back with the Tenor Sousaphone. Got myself a Kelly 5G glow-in-the-dark medium shank. Fits right in there, as well as any other mouthpiece does. We're gonna see if we can bring some color to music and improve the Tenor Sousaphone. No, we can't. I'm gonna play you an excerpt from Rudimental Regiment, one of my favorite Bruce Pearson songs. And we'll see if I can do it any justice. Just remember, playing faster means less time for them to notice you're out of tune. Let's compare that to something I'm a little more comfortable with, the stock mouthpiece, which is very small. Let's see how this sounds. Increased cup depth definitely improves the sound versus this, but I'm not very good at big mouthpieces, you know? Easier on this little guy, I'll tell you that. Yeah, it's pretty hard to play an instrument in the bass range when, you know, your concert F, G, whatever, your 1 and 3 low note is one of the worst notes on the horn, like weaker than the false tone beneath it. I'll doodle a little more on here. But yeah, this doesn't help. It sounds good, but it doesn't help. Big honking mouthpieces, jeez. I need to give my 44E4 back. Oh man. No. Kelly 5G is a perfectly good mouthpiece. I tell you what, you dump this in your medium shank euphonium, you'll be sounding fine. Feels good. Sounds good and everything. Just not for me, and it doesn't help this at all. Not one lick. I'll tell you what, it's still pretty fun, even if it doesn't play in tune. Might not be doing any multi-track ensembles with myself anytime soon, but it's alright, you get you some of this.